depend on the middle class in a revolutionary movement. It is the workers and kisans who formed the backbone of any revolutionary movement. This was the first message from Netaji when we started recruiting women for the Rani of Jhansi Regiment. I am Lakshmi Sehgal and these were my days in the Indian National Army. I came from a political family and was very interested to take part in the national movement. I completed studying medicine at the Madras Medical College in 1940. By this time, the Second World War had broken out and there was a need for doctors in the British Indian Army. The Japanese had attacked Singapore on December 8, 1941. Raj Bihari Bose, who was a veteran freedom fighter, had come along with the Japanese. He was the one who started the India Independence League. Although I joined the league, I could only do welfare works and underground broadcast. Soon after Netaji reached Singapore, Raj Bihari Bose handed over the leadership of the league to him. It was his intention to start a women's infantry in the name of Rani of Jhansi, who fought so heroically against the Britishers in 1857. Training had started for Rani of Jhansi Regiment in Singapore and Rangoon from October 23, 1943. It lasted for 3 months and it was very rigorous. We all had to wear khaki uniforms with pants and bush shirt. We all had to cut our hair short. I had hair below my knees which my mother had never allowed me to cut. So I was very glad to cut my hair short and never grew it back since. Our regiment could move only up to the middle of Burma. As the attack on Imphal by the INA was supported by the Japanese army and was repulsed by the heavily reinforced British garrisons. The regiment had to face many heavy casualties and after suffering heavy casualties, it had to withdraw. However, the regiment was soon disbanded. In this connection, I would like to say that all the members of the regiment, without any exception, had signed a petition to Netaji, signed in their own blood saying that they were ready to die in the battlefield but did not want to retreat. At this stage, I had joined an INA hospital which was set up for the wounded and for the incapacitated INA personnel. We were heavily bombed and the hospital was destroyed. I was kept under house arrest and in 1946, I was released and then taken back to India. Back in India, the INA trials had attracted massive public attention. After independence, I returned back to my medical practice.
Favorite personality, Sarojini Naidu. Sarojini Naidu was born in a Bengali family in Hyderabad. She was an Indian political activist and a poet. She was an important figure in Indian struggle of independence. Sarojini Naidu was also known as the Nightingale of India or Bharat Kokila. Now I am going to present two quotes of Sarojini Naidu. When there is oppression, the only self-respecting thing is to rise and say this. Shall cease today because my right is justice. If you are stronger, you have to help the weaker. Boy or girl, both in play and in the work. We want deeper sincerity of motive, greater courage in speech and earnestness in action. Thank you.
India must be freed. India must be a republic. India must be united. This flag is of Indian independence. Behold, it is born. It has been made sacred by the blood of young Indians who sacrificed their lives for India. I call upon you, gentlemen, to rise and salute this flag of Indian independence. I appeal to the numbers of freedom all over the world. Born on 24th September 1861. I'm an Indian revolutionary and I took active participation in Indian independence movement. I'm also known as Daughter of India. In my first part of my career, I went to London. I set up a free Indian society in London. And later on, I went to Paris and set up a center there. I was the first one to host the first Indian national flag in foreign soil. I wave the flag before the vast assembly. I appeal the delegates to support India in order to free themselves from the British rule. I tried my best to spread awareness among the Indians about the harm brought by fighting against the imperialist forces. The fulfillment of life lies in dedicating oneself to one's country. So I call upon you, march forward. We are for India and India is for Indians. Thank you.
I, Rani Lakshmibai, the Queen of Jhansi, is an Indian queen of the Marathi princely states of Jhansi. I was one of the leading figures of the Indian Rebellion of 1857 and became a symbol of resistance for the British Raj for the Indian nationalities. I was born on 19th November 1828 in the town of Varanasi. My father Moropant Tambe and my mother Bhagirathi Sapre are from Maharashtra. I was educated at home, able to read and write, and was more independent in my childhood than the other children of my age. I was married to the Maharaja of Jhansi, Gangadhar Rao. I was trained with shooting and horse riding. I contrasted many of the cultural expectations of the women in the Indian societies at this time. I was accoutred on riding on horsebacks with escorts from the palace to the temple. My palace, which is known as the Rani Mahal, is now converted into a museum, which is very popular now.
Namaste. I was born as Aruna Ganguly into a Bengali family and married a progressive barrister and freedom fighter by the name of Asaf Ali, who was 23 years senior to me. My marriage to a Muslim was opposed initially, but then I tried to prove that religion is never a bar in the fight for independence. I am an Indian educator, political activist and publisher. As my husband was a prominent member in the INC, our marriage brought me in touch with many political leaders, and that's how I entered into politics. I am a revolutionary leftist who picked up the mantle of leadership during the Quit India movement in 1942. After India finally won its hard-fought independence, I devoted most of my time in working for social causes like women empowerment and workers' movement. What I'd like to tell you is that no matter which creed, caste, community and religion we belong to, we must always follow our constitution, its rules and regulations. We must live with honesty and always put our country first. Only this kind of progressive attitude can lead to a new and developed India. After all, he who is not courageous enough to take risk will achieve nothing in life. Thank you.